say, it's actually a pretty nice view. Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play. Another one? I like games. Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games.
What's your point?
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out which one. This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we've got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
That blows.
Well, shit. That was my last quarter. You?
Quarterless.
Damn.
Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh yeah? Let's see what you got.
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her. Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool.
Don't axe, don't fell.
I've been saying sorry all morning. I admit it was really dumb to lock the keys in the car. You've been on me for 3 hours.
Hey, spare some change?
Sorry, we might have some leftover food when we're done.
What? No, I'm not. What kind of food?
This place has really gone downhill.
Shh. She's right there. Get out of here, woodland creatures. Have some self-respect.
I don't want to head down there just yet.
I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
I guess you could stab someone with a nail file.
Oh, right.
Sure, let's try it. Damn it. It always looks so easy in the movies. Wonder if I can find something sturdier to use. What's worse than groveling for change? Groveling for change and fail. My hierarchy of needs goes pot, then beer, then wine. Still, wino has a classy ring to it. Whoa, that's badass. There's gotta be something freeing about being able to build your home wherever you are, from whatever is around you. Yuck. Cliche much, AW and OL? I wonder if I could use this to get the quarter out. Stealing a dedication plate takes persistence. Press got power, activate. I win. That was enough of a game for me.
Your MacGyver skills are second to none. Except, probably, MacGyver.
Rachel smells like jasmine? Is she smelling me right now, too? Really should have showered this morning.
All right, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
That's it? I do that in my head during, like, every class.
See? You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
Hey, what do you say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here?
God, you just have the best ideas.
Loving this guy.
What's he thinking right now?
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful in its own way. What's going on with these two?
And the Lord saideth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
No one, son. Now, lean into the grill and see if the fire started. Further.
Further.
Wow. That was dark. Too dark.
Perfect dark.
They totally stole my third grade art project.
Wow. You made that?
Can't you tell?
It does have a certain give zero fucks quality that I recognize.
Sweet beanie.
What do you suppose she's thinking?
Nature's Wi-Fi sucks.
Maybe there's a squirrel family around here with broadband.
If only I can guess their password.
We love nuts, 69.
Dingoes ate our babies, 13.
Too soon.
This is fun. Who's next? Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder.
Ooh, jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1.
Nailed it.
Damn, they are really going at it.
Oh, honey. I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double.
Rachel? Hey, are you all right?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
I don't know. I might still be hungover from last night.
Wrong answer. You don't ask a girl out and then not buy her a drink.
They have a bottle of wine. Let's steal it.
Okay. Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead.
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Can we help you?
Oh my God!
Holy shit. Talk about committing to a performance. Better act fast.
Oh, thank God. Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go!
Don't look at me. Look at Baywatch over here. Aw, I don't remember how to do CPR. Wah. It's time to nut up or shut up.
Watch out. I'm going to check her pulse. That's on her neck, right?
I still think you should go get help. There's a ranger station on the other side of the park.
Good point. We'll keep watch while you go.
Oh, shit! That sounds like rabies to me.
Rabies?
Yep, definitely rabies. Better pay close attention to make sure she doesn't try to bite you.
Okay. You can do this. I can't do it.
Pathetic.
Look. He's clearly useless. This woman needs help from someone who actually knows what they're doing.
Hey, look at me! Do you want to be locked out of the car of life forever?
Or are you ready to break in there and seize the keys to your potential?
Oh my god. You're right.
Hey, wow. I'm all better now. You saved my life. From the bottom of my heart, thank you. Yeah, good work, everyone. Peace out.
That was incredible. You're a hero.
Huh. I guess I am.
Here. You earned this.
Thanks. I could use a drink after trying to keep up with you.
I am excessively sober right now.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving now.
Whoa. Hey, check this out.
What?
Great. It's a pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash.
Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe.
I'm gonna go sit down. Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal? I've heard that actors are moody, but wow, Rachel.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that all right with you?
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't.
Fuck! Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently, she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that.
Score.
Hey, check it out.
I don't always drink beer.
But when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Home run!
Can I see?
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously, fuck you.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go. Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly? I mean, fuck. Are you actually going to make me say it?
Say what exactly?
You know, like a friendship. But more.
Ah.
I know. Weird, right? It's just, today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize whatever's going on between us is special. Come on, say something.
Chloe, I'm sorry. I am really, really sorry. But I can't, even though I want to.
Why not? Because I can't. I know it isn't fair, but it's how it is. Goodbye, Chloe.
Fuck this place.
You know she's fake, yet you can't take your eyes off her. Who else do I know who fits that description? Yeah! Fuck off, Rachel. I've never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras. If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools. Fuck you, David.
Dad.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on?
What's past is prologue and shit.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
Where's my marker? Oh, there it is.
Gotta say, that was some fight. A lover's quarrel, you might say? She nearly took your head off.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
Dad used to hate it when I wrote on shit. I guess I did that.
Sometimes people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
Rachel!
You came. I'm glad.
Hey. I couldn't let the day end with whatever this afternoon was.
Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat, and how calm he was, and the sound of his voice, and just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Hey, we were both kind of the queen of shitty.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that. More like blind desperation. And maybe a slight buzz from that wine.
I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? You dropped that one guy with a knee to the balls.
Only because you showed up at the last minute, and...
What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan? You got right in his face and called him out.
That was pretty sweet, actually.
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
Fuck your dad.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever.
Okay.
Can I borrow your lighter? Thank you.
Come on.